Do you have an idea what this strange tube is and what it has to do with standard transceivers? If you're interested, stick around and we'll check it out, and I will even explain how it works. If you haven't recognized it yet, we're talking about helium neon lasers. Those lasers were invented in the 60s of the last century, and by the way, laser is an acronym. It stands for light amplification by stimulated emission of radiation. Here we have, in this sketch, we have the principle of such a laser. So we have a small laser tube. It's a glass tube with a diameter of 1 millimeter or so. And around it, there's a glass bulb, which is hermetically sealing the whole setup. In this setup, we have the two gases, helium and neon, at a low pressure. And the special point is we are able, or it's possible, to excite those atoms or those gases, and this is done by those two electrodes which are connected to a high voltage source, 10 to 15,000 volts. And now the question is, how is this excitement working? If you go over here on the left hand side at the top, we have a sketch. On the left side is helium, on the right side we have neon, and those horizontal lines, they are indicating energy states which are possible for the electron. So if we now put the high voltage to this bulb, so we have an electrical discharge, the electrons of the helium can be raised from the base level to this high state. In combination with the neon, it has a quite similar energy state. It is possible by collision that this helium atom transfers its energy to the neon. This means an electron of the neon, which was at the base level, is raised to this top level. If we now go to the left-hand side on the bottom here, we can see the neon has an intermediate state, I would say. So if this electron is falling from the top state to this intermediate state, it's spontaneously emitting photons. It has a wavelength of 632.8 nanometers. This means it's a red color. This is not yet a laser, but it's the starting point for the laser. The special thing is, if we have those inverted electron states, if a photon is passing by this neon, it stimulates this electron to fall down to the intermediate state. This basically means it's cloning itself, because it has the same polarization, it has this, the same direction, it's flying, and so on and so forth. Now, this is not yet a laser, but it's the basic principle of the laser, because we have to make sure that this does not only happen from time to time, it has to happen continuously, so we get kind of an avalanche. If we now go back to this sketch of the principle of the laser, we can see here on the right-hand side and on the left-hand side, we have mirrors. Those mirrors act as a resonator, so this means the light is traveling from right to left, always causing this stimulated emission. And like that, we get the amplification of those photons with a highly coherent beam. Now the question is, how do we get the light out of this setup, out of the resonator? It's quite simple. On the right side, we have a 100% reflector. On the left side, we have a, for example, 99% reflector. So this means continuously 1% of the radiation is skipped out, and this is the radiation we are using. It is obvious we cannot put such a helium neon laser inside a transceiver. This doesn't work. But nowadays, there are semiconductor lasers which are existing, and the principle is quite similar. Perhaps this is a topic for one of the next videos, and so another reason to become a follower of our channel. I hope you learned something today. If so, please leave a comment, and see you in one of the next videos. Bye-bye.